helper. It's enormous. Crazy.
What is it? Oh, that's kind of cool. Man, that's some murky stuff. Get all the tannins in it. That's what makes it that color. It's all the stuff leaching out from the plants and the roots and all that. It's crazy. Or I think it is. Yeah, or I think it is.
That one's huge.
Yeah, they're all over this tree. Look at that tree leaning.
Widowmaker.
Heck yeah. That is a big one.
There's a bear cub in there.
It freaking looks like it's a bear cave. If I was a bear, I'd like it in there.
It's a little soggy.
Soggy bottom, boys.
This is a root. That's a root, too.
It's like Jurassic Park.
It is.
Look at this mushroom. It's really nice just being able to walk and not worry about snakes. You know, because that's the only thing I think about most times back home.
Memory foam forest floor.
Yeah.
Super squishy. Oh. Looking flawless. I hear you, little birdies. They must be way up there.
Two juvenile eagles up here. One just flew in, screeching at us. Look at that. There's one in the tree. Let's see if I can get closer. Hear them? Yes. There they are. Look. Sorry, it's so shaky. White tails until about 4 or 5. Look how big they are. Look. still went up in the tree. This is super shaky. I'm sorry. Here comes the zip line. Take it. There's the coast. Huh. Rubber lining. Oh, look, there's trail markers on that tree. See them? It's an old school way. They put some right here, too.
Mm-hmm. I was just intrigued that you had to actually climb up something.
You know what? This might have been, this might have been an old observation area, and they bolted onto the trees, and these were cross beams that ran.
Yeah, that's what it looks like. Yeah, because it's on this side too.
The vegetation's a little different here.
Uh-huh.
Like
the heads of the,
it's like,
it looks like seaweed. Looks like cilantro.
Wild cilantro in Alaska. This is just crazy stuff to walk through. I mean, there's no flat ground, is there?
Uh-uh. My feet are constantly adjusting to the terrain.
And look, just a sheer drop off. To the coast, and all that stuff washed up there. I mean, this is crazy. It's beautiful, but
everything is sopping wet.
What? I mean, I wonder what this trail is.
I don't know. I just found it.
Well, if we keep the coast to our left, we'll know where to go. Here's some biking.
Is that dry?
Yeah, kinda. Well, it's damp. drier.
I've noticed all these kind of little pocket holes everywhere. Oh, look at this.
Tell you what, I'm starting to build up some sweat doing this. I mean, it's up and down and up and down.
You want to keep going?
Yeah. I mean, this is a pretty nice trail compared to what you see just off the side of it, you know. Like, this has been walked on enough.
You lose your footing, you're going straight down.
Gotta be careful to not wander too far back in here. I didn't bring a compass with me. I didn't know if it would get through customs and crap. Because we're pretty much just wandering in the woods now. And there's the trail again. It picks back up. I can see it. That's not stable. What's it? That one was a doozy.
That was a big one.
Here's some pink flagging tape. That's something to remember. And it's 9:58. Oh, here's another doozy. I mean, the hardest part about it is that your feet are never stable. Like,
I feel like my feet are constantly trying to grip on.
Yeah, like you're never. Wow. There's a good size hole. There's another big hole right here. I mean, you can see the trail through here. I think that looks like wild asparagus. See it?
Uh-huh.
You think that's that purple asparagus he was talking about?
Maybe.
This is just crazy.
There's holes everywhere.
I know. You're just asking for a leg breaker. You know, I think this is a game trail that we're walking on.
Oh, gosh.
You want to head back?
Yeah.
Or do you want to go right up here and look? Just a little further. Like what my buddy Travis Henry says. Just stay a little bit longer so we can go a little bit further. Not cool. I know, it's intense. And here's the coast. Look at that. Don't want to push my luck here. It's a sheer cliff drop off. We're standing up pretty high. Beautiful mountains in the background. This would be a great shot right here, Jess. If you want to take a picture of, I can get a picture of you. Mm-hmm. So we're sitting here taking photos and stuff of this really pretty shot. And out, we hear the blow. We've kind of gotten accustomed to what the, we've kind of gotten accustomed to what the blow what to hole. Listen to for the blowhole. And there's a humpback whale.
I don't know if we can see right out the here. Trees, though.
I've got a little shot right here I can zoom in on.
There it is.
Where? There he is. Yep.
You see it?
Mm-hmm. Got him. Right there.
Oh my god.
Right there.
Look how close it is to the shoreline.
I know. This is just worth watching and not even trying to film it, you know, just making a memory. So, part of the reason, well, we didn't, okay, so we're in, we're in Icy Strait, Alaska. We've got Ketchikan tomorrow.
Uh-huh. Then a day at sea.
And then
Victoria,
Canada. So, we didn't have any excursion booked today. You're going to have to break with me if I have to manage through some of this. It's kind of crazy trail. Whoa, look at this. That's cool. Okay, so so we didn't book an excursion today, and I talked with one of the gentlemen we've met on the ship, and he is an avid outdoorsman. He actually used to work for...
Shout out to Hardy.
Yeah, Hardy, you're awesome, man. He's actually spent a majority, not a majority of his time, but a good amount of time in the Arctic Circle camping, and he doing work up there. He used to work for the Smithsonian, and so he's really knowledgeable. He knows all about the flora and the fauna and the coastal life and all that, so... He suggested today, and here comes a, hold on.
Doozy.
Yep. Okay, here, let me help you. He suggested today that we just, there's a big hole right there, that we just not do an excursion and wander through the trails of this area because it was available to do that. There's another doozy, hold on. This pack is starting to because this isn't a really big city, a little like compared to Juneau and all that we've been to, and it's just been awesome. I mean, this is one of the funnest things we've done so far. I think it's just every day gets better and better, but
you're just away from all the people too.
Exactly, that's what I was about to say. I mean, look at this. It's just beautiful. We've got the coast over here to our right. And we're just walking through some trail that we found. We haven't seen a single person on this one. But it's just awesome. I mean, this is just untamed, wild wilderness.
Unkept.
Yeah.
Unmanicured.
And, oh, there's a, you can hear the cruise ship.
Barely. It's just real muffled.
Wait for that to die down. But oh, there's a cool looking shot right there. Try not to tumble down this cliff. Wait for Boo Boo to stop talking. So anyway, sorry I was mumbling a lot, but we just took his advice, and we've just been wandering around out here for probably a little over an hour now, and it's just been the best. Well, there you go. You can hold it by the handle. I can edit all this stuff out.
Okay.
But it's just been the best because this is what I want to do when I come to this stuff. I love the excursions and I loved the boat trips that we had, you know, and getting to see the different whales and otters and stuff, but just being able to personally walk on this stuff and touch the different trees and plants. And I mean, like earlier, we were walking through the woods, we went off the trail and we're just kind of cutting the corner really, and hear the screeching and stuff of an eagle. We look up and there's a huge juvenile flying through the woods up above us, and then he lands on a branch, and right next to him is another juvenile, and they kind of squawked at each other for a little while, and then, you know, the one took off and the other one stayed there, and I actually got to walk right underneath him. I mean, literally just looking right at him and him looking down at me and turning his head and stuff. It's lifetime experiences. I mean, this is something that, you know, I feel like you and I can both talk about, and hey, remember when we were wandering through the woods in Alaska, you know?
Crazy too is that not everyone gets to do this. Not everyone gets to visit this state, you know, and it's beautiful. I mean, it's different than Colorado, than New Mexico, than the places that I visited as far as the woodlands, you know?
Yeah. It's like what we said earlier, it's almost prehistoric, you know? It feels like, I mean, there's no trash. I've seen pink flagging tape on the ground.
But that's it.
And that's it. I mean, there's no trash. No trash. And where can you go in the woods and experience that, you know? I just can't get over it. And you get a new appreciation for the, you know, the natives that lived on this land a long time ago, and then even the ones that are still toughing it out up here. It really is unbelievable. You walk in these woods for an hour and you're exhausted. You know, I mean, your feet hurt, your knees hurt because you're never on stable ground.
Or you're bracing yourself.
I mean, it's unreal. Like, you're constantly shifting your feet because you're trying to grip and get a hold of stuff. You know, there's a couple of spots in a trail where it's easy walking. I mean, and then that's it. You enjoy it and then you're going weaving through stuff. But it's awesome. I wish we didn't have to go. So we're gonna get back out of here and then we're gonna go wander down this coastline and look at all that stuff too. I can't even begin to imagine what we're gonna find down there. So hang with us. Can still hear that whale blowing. Did you just hear him? He just blew out a big out of his blowhole. There's our ship.
So which balcony is ours? There wasn't any next to
pretty little stream.
Now could you drink off of this?
Yeah, I mean, boil it. I would for sure. Being this close to the trail.
Oh, especially if you look at the collection down below.
That's awesome.
No, you'll find tons, I'm sure. Be careful on these rocks.
Yeah. Like, it looks so strong.
Here's another big one.
Look at this.
Oh. It's like dried up barnacles.
That's crazy.
So, just scared two full-grown bald eagles, white heads and everything. How's this one here? See it. And this tree, literally, right here. I know the sun is blaring right now, but it sure feels good to be out in the sun. And look at all these little critters. Urchins and all kinds of stuff. Oh, look at this rock, Jess.
Yeah.
That was too cool with those eagles.
Yeah, that was awesome.
I mean, they were right there. I didn't even see them.
I just heard something.
The tide has actually been, I mean, look, this is all still wet. It hasn't been down long. We might start actually seeing some live stuff. Yeah. Yeah, all these are closed.
So they must have just come up, huh?
I mean, within the last few hours, I imagine. This is all soaking wet down here.
What's that?
I don't know, some kind of kelp or seaweed or algae or something. Crazy. One extreme to the next. All right, so we're gonna meander our way back through
the tiptoe our way.
Man, this is some crazy slippery stuff, but we're gonna, oh gee, that one's not even opened yet.
Oh my gosh, that one's, yeah, I'll leave that one here.
And we're gonna head back towards a little town, and I think there's an awesome little donut shop that we saw that we're gonna have to stop at, right?
Oh yeah.
So
get some coffee. I haven't had coffee this morning.
Heck yeah. So, we will get back with you. It's a cool cave. Our little depression. Straight up. And straight down.
That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool.
That's a raven. My ass is all frozen. Kind of over here. There he is.
From that place back there?
Sorry.
All right, Travis Henry. Want you to know I'm thinking about you, man. You and Mr. Major. Got some nice rocks here that I'm skipping in Alaska. This one's gonna be good. You ready? I almost don't want to skip it because it's perfect.
Look at all these spruce tips. One of the places that we went to in Skagway made a spruce tip ale, and it was unbelievable. It's really good. Look at all the old man's beard. Bruce.